Hello,
I'm Norm Rasmussen, the founder of the Precious Testimonies Evangelistic Ministries, along with my dear sweetheart wife, Kathleen. What a privilege it is to be used of God to help other people connect with God and grow in their relationship with Him. It's what we're all about. You have no doubt read the title of this video. Are you struggling, feeling worthy that God would forgive you for all the wrong you've done? Do you believe you don't deserve, in other words, forgiveness from God? I'm not quite sure the title that you're reading here, because we put various titles, but the thought is many people, or some people anyway, just don't feel like God would forgive them for all of the terrible things they have done. Well, my friend, this is your moment in time to hear the truth of the matter. No human being is worthy enough to receive God's forgiveness. None. None of us. That's absolutely correct. Matter of fact, when you understand God and how He views sin that is permeated in the human race, God has said in the Holy Bible that He will not tolerate sin in His presence, His full presence. He will not tolerate it. Okay? And so what do we do about that? Does that mean none of us are worthy enough to be forgiven of all the wrongdoing that we've done against Him and others? Ah, my friend, God died for people who are unworthy. He died for the most least deserving of forgiveness. That's you and I. Okay? That's the truth of the matter. Okay? Now, here is something that you need to know that maybe you've never heard. Once you die, and you are in the presence of God, okay, and let's just say it kind of goes this way. Let's say that God asks you, well, you want to go to heaven for eternity, right? And you say, of course. well, then, do you believe that I paid full penalty for your past, present, and future sins? Because it will be Jesus Christ that's the judge. The Bible says Jesus Christ is going to be the one that God the Father allows to judge each of us. Okay? He paid the price to receive that high honor, by the way, by dying on the cross for each and every one of us. Okay? He's going to say, why? Well, let's just say it's a hypothetical. And he asks, why do you feel like I should let you spend eternity with me? Well, here's the answer you want to share. Well, I believe the gospel message, which is that God the Father sent Jesus Christ, the Son, or the second person of the triune Godhead, down from heaven, be born in a little baby, in the form of a little baby, just like the rest of us. He lived 33 years before he was crucified and sent into eternity. Yet he never sinned one time. And because he never sinned one time, that made him the only acceptable sacrifice God the Father would accept to pay ransom payment for all of our wrongdoing. Pay ransom payment for all of our sins, past, present, and future. Sins that we've yet to commit, but will. And God knows we will. Okay? And it's because you paid full penalty for my sin, Jesus. That's why I believe I'm forgiven for all of my sins and made clean, so that I am acceptable to you to stay with you for all eternity. And he's going to say, yep, that's what qualifies you to be in heaven. Now, how are you going to handle it when he says, receive my godly royalty? Royalty. You see, in the Romans, in the book of Romans in the New Testament, chapter 8, it says God's people, the disciples of Jesus Christ, they are going to reign with God and co-reign with Jesus Christ for all eternity. Okay? So that makes them royalty. That makes truly saved, truly born again Christians, those who truly mean business with God in alignment with truth, Bible truth, their immediate royalty the moment they make Jesus Christ their personal Lord and Savior. Immediately. They aren't deserving of it. They aren't worthy of it. Okay? The only thing we're worthy of as Christians is to be sentenced eternally to hell for our sins. Okay? But the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ is I've removed that penalty from each and every human being on planet Earth if they will reach out and forgive my pardon. Okay? My pardon is I died on the cross to pardon you of all your sins. And because I am worthy and you're not, I am going to impart my worthiness to you. I'm going to impart my royalty to you, in fact. Now, I won't get into all how that's going to be in the promise. If you'll read below on this video clip, there's a link to a writing, and it'll explain that more in detail, and I would certainly encourage you to go there. But you're just going to have to believe that I'm hearing from the Holy Spirit on this, and I'm speaking on behalf of God, which I am. Okay, and I humbly say that. My friend, it's mind-boggling. You see, here's the truth of the matter. God is looking for unworthy people to lavish them immediately with royalty status, godly royalty status. But you can't get that other than making Jesus Christ your personal Lord and Savior. There is no other way that God will lavish a mere human being, sinner, okay, from birth, because of the sin we have inherited from Adam and Eve, all the way down to, to ourselves in the bloodline and spiritually, I'm sure. We'll know quite how that all works. I don't think any of us does. We'll know about it once we get into glory in heaven with God. But my friend, truth of the matter is, those who make it with God in eternity that he wants with him, for eternity, they're going to have a sense of knowing. They don't deserve this royalty that they've been given. They don't deserve to be forgiven of all their wrongdoing that they committed while they were on earth, okay? They don't deserve it. But they're going to have a sense of royalty. Oh, God, I don't deserve this, but oh, I am so thankful because you've given it to me, free of charge, no less, by simply accepting Jesus as my Lord and Savior while I was on earth. So my friend, and there won't be pain with that, don't misunderstand, there won't be any pain in heaven. He's not going to allow that. There won't be any pain. It'll just be something that will trigger more joy in us, more appreciation than anything that we can fathom, okay? And that is so wonderful. That's wonderful. So my friend, the devil's telling you lies if he says, if you're hearing that you're not worthy enough to be forgiven for all the wrong you've done, it's a lie from the devil. God wants to forgive you so quick of all that you have done. All you have to do is ask him, and he will. Simple as that. He promises he will. Now, it may take you a little time to grasp this incredible revelation, all right? Be patient with God, but I assure you the time will come when you will have full peace in your heart. Yes, there's no amount of sins that God won't forgive. There's no amount of wrongdoing we can do that God won't forgive. He paid the price. He paid it all. He paid the price for every human being who ever was or will be born on this planet. He paid the price so their sins could be forgiven. And they could be granted royalty status. Don't hold on another moment, my friend, to the lies that the devil has brainwashed you with. God so much wants to grant you royalty status. It's free. No charge. Too priceless, we couldn't afford to pay for it if all the money in the world, all the wealth in the world was at our disposal. God says, nope. Too costly, too priceless. No human being, can earn it. No human being is worthy enough of it, but because I love you. I'm going to grant you royalty status. The salvation, it is more incredible than what we can fathom. Reach out and get Jesus, my friend. Don't wait another day. He's longing to forgive you. Thanks for hearing me out.